Welcome on another DDS tutorial video. This one is a part 2 of how to set alarm limits video. We will talk about another possibility, how to set alarm limits. There are many people who do not use the alarm limits. Most of them probably tried to use them, but they didn't set the limits properly. Then they received many false alarms or no alarms at all, and they simply quit using alarm limits. It saves a lot of your time if you set the alarm limits properly. Imagine that you return from the road measurements. You load the data from data collector into DDS software, and from this time you can see new alarms. But how to set alarm limits properly? You know that every machine and every point doesn't vibrate in the same way. Machine condition is one reason. Transmission between the vibration source, usually the bearing, and the measurement point is another reason. Also, proper mounting of accelerometer is very important. It is very difficult to use any standards because of above reasons. You should think about each individual machine, what vibration level is optimal for it. Setting of limits by statistics is the tool how to set reasonable alarm limits. The statistical alarms generation works with all measured values or readings from the past. The statistical process finds a normal values and offers alarm limits to you. You can apply the limits by statistics for one point, for many points together, or for a group of machines if they are the same or very similar type. You can select all required three items and all data from them will be used. See how to do it in DDS. I select only one data cell or measurement type if you like. For example, the velocity data cell. Selected data cell has to contain some good condition data. It means measurements which were taken when the machine was in good condition. Now I select the limits by statistics function and all cells together option. I will explain these two options later. The function firstly analyzes all vibration values of selected data cell. Then it uses the statistical approach and gives back the limit values. I push apply and limits will be written to data cell. I have used the velocity overall data cell as an example, but this function can analyze any static data cell. It is not limited only to velocity as the ISO 10816 standard. Now I show you how to analyze more than one data cell together. I use the filter function and I select all velocity data cells. I am looking for VEL in the name. 1,033 data cells are selected. That's a huge number. Now I click on Set Limits by Statistics button. I can choose from two options. All cells together means that all measured values from all data cells are processed together at once. The same limit values will be set to all selected cells. The cells individually is the second option. Each data cell values will be processed individually. Each cells gets different limit values. I can display the text report with all processed data cells. As you can see, The using of set limits by statistics function is very simple and it gives you great improvement of your diagnostic methods. Thank you for watching.